Our coverage of Computex 2025 from Taipei, Taiwan is brought to you by Gigabyte, Trix, Thermaltake, G-Skill, and Cooler Master.
Hey guys, if you can't tell by the color scheme, I am at Noctua, and they have like actually a lot of products here, and they even have some products that are launching very soon, including a brand new Gen 2 version of the NF-A12X25. Let's start over there. Here's the NF-A12X25G2. Now, the one thing I'm not going to be able to tell you guys really is pricing here. Noctua is sharing pricing for the European area, but for US pricing, it's just really tough to gauge right now because of the whole tariff situation and everything. So the main thing we want to talk about with the NF-A12X25 is that it's better. Obviously, if you're going to make a Gen 2 of something, you should improve it to some degree. Also, I like that they have both a Noctua tan and brown version here. They also have an all-black version. It's still made of that same LCP material, but let's check a little cheat sheet here and see what else they did. Progressive bend impeller, that's the blade, still make it made of that LCP material. A centrifugal turbulator hub, which sounds like it's made up by a child, but that also sounds really cool. Centrifugal turbulator hub. For better flow attachment, winglet. The winglet's on the fan to reduce the vortices, again to reduce vibration and noise generation. And of course that ultra tight tip clearance of 0.5 millimeters to make sure you have maximum static pressure and you don't have any air leakage. This is coming out in June. That's like next month. Here are a couple side-by-side charts. Note that these do not start at zero, so once you take that into account, you can see the dBA reduction. This is in a few different configurations with the radiator on an NHU-12A and case cooling performance. And these are noise normalized charts, so basically you're looking at lower temperature with the 200 watt heat load on a water cooling radiator. Lower temperature with an air cooler, the NHU-12A, and then increased air flow when put in a case. One of the other cool things about this fan is that when you put it up against something, I mean obviously not a flat surface like this, but up against the radiator that creates some resistance, most fans are going to slightly reduce their RPMs. Noctua says with the G2 version of the NF-A12X25, that's not a problem. It's going to maintain those RPMs. One thing that can happen when you have multiple fans installed in the same system is you can have harmonic vibrations that sort of build upon each other, leading to these peaks that are noticeable that you hear, and Noctua hates it when you hear their fans. So they're going to make these fans available in a 2-pack. I don't think that's the packaging that we're looking at here, but either fan in that 2-pack will have a slight offset in terms of the RPM, and that's going to reduce those peaks and make it a nice, smooth auditory experience. Now, because Noctua has a fancy new fan, they're going to be integrating that in some new products, some collaborations with some of their partners. This is a Seasonic power supply, the Prime PX HPD. This has been available in a 1600 watt version in the past, which was fairly lengthy. It was like 230 millimeters long or something like that. This one is much shorter. They brought it down to 125 millimeters. Of course, they've dropped the wattage a little bit as well. They're aiming for 850 watt, 1000 watt, and 1200 watt options. Higher end versions will have two 12V2x6 connectors. This being a Noctua edition, it's of course got the Noctua brown colors, but this is still in development, so don't expect this to launch until Q2 2026. Noctua peripherals. Did you know Noctua makes keyboards and mice? You probably didn't know that because they don't. They collaborate with other people who are really good at making keyboards and mice. This is the Drop Plus Mito right here, which is made from double shot ABS keycaps. I'm definitely not like the keyboard expert in the tech space or anything like that, but it definitely got the Noctua colors nailed right there. This is a very high-end mouse. It's going to have an MSRP around $200 or so. It's made by Pulsar. It's the Feynman mouse, which is, I believe, their highest-end model. A 32,000 DPI sensor, but if you can see, right there in the middle is a Noctua fan. So Pulsar is going to have a bunch of different colors, of course, available with this, and they will integrate that fan. So when you're using the mouse and you have your hand right there, oh, it gives you a nice bit of breeze. And given that it's hot and muggy here in Taiwan, I'm totally feeling that breeze on my hand right now when the fan spins up. It's also a very lightweight mouse. You can see all the cutouts there. I just thought it was very interesting. And again, the Noctua color scheme, they've gotten a lot of... Sometimes Noctua gets a hard time over its color scheme, but the tan and brown, I feel like, is really working well here. They veered a little bit away from that maroon that it used to be, I think. Here's a GPU that was on display over at the Asus booth, but I didn't get much of a chance to look at it, so it's cool to take a look here. This is not an RTX 5090. The RTX 5090s sell so well that all of the cool special edition versions of 5090s are pretty much pointless. They don't need to put any extra effort into them. So this super overbit cooler, which is 4+ slots, and features three of the new Noctua NFA12X25G2 fans, is an RTX 5080. Noctua says it actually performs better in terms of cooling than the ASUS ROG Astral, which is their top-end card. So while I do find that impressive, I really wish NVIDIA would produce more GPUs and focus more of their fab time on gaming versus all that AI stuff, so that we could have, like, this would be way cooler if it was a 5090, to be perfectly honest. It is cool as is. Here's another Noctua collaboration with Antec. This is the Antec Flux Pro Noctua Edition. Now, you might think that Antec was like, well, we need to make something that's Noctua colors, we'll paint it brown, we'll make it match with the brown and tan color scheme, and then we'll call it a day. But no, this is Noctua we're talking about. They're not just gonna focus on the aesthetics, although this is a very nice looking case. We got some wood accents along the edge. We have a Noctua logo right there next to Antec. That's very nice. I've really been liking the wood accents on cases lately. But Noctua wanted to make sure that this case is also going to perform better than alternative options out there. So here you can see with the high heat load scenario, regular scenario, we have both the CPU on the top and the GPU on the bottom. Basically, if you go with the standard or stock Flux fans that ship with the Antec Flux case, add in the Noctua fans, and whatever temperature you're looking at, you're going to have a noise level that is that much lower. That's how to read these charts right here. That applies to both the CPU and the GPU, both in a more standard configuration as well as a heavy load scenario. And Noctua is not afraid of saying that, yeah, like, at some points when you have the temperature down low enough with the fan RPMs high enough, it's not going to make a difference. And that's okay. Noctua is one of the most honest companies, I think, when it comes to providing the information that they have gained and being like, yes, here's where it will help and here's where it might not. One thing Noctua has not done is an AIO, so that is what they're working on. An all-in-one liquid cooler from Noctua. This one is still in development. The ETA for launch is Q1 2026. They partner with Asetek for the pump on this one, so it's using a Gen 8 pump. But Noctua did what Noctua does, and they completely over-engineered the housing in order to reduce or eliminate as much vibrations as possible. This is 3D printed, but it's representing a foam pad. They didn't want to show the actual foam that they're using because those are trade secrets. But you can see it's a sandwich, so you have higher and lower density foam that's going to block both the higher frequency and lower frequency vibrations. This little guy sits in the housing like so, and then that goes on top of the pump block. On top is a little Noctua logo that's held on by a magnet, and they're also going to have this little fan that you can pop on there as well. So this optional 80mm auxiliary fan is going to provide more airflow around your VRMs, and they've even tapered the cone of it here in order to direct that airflow. But that's not all. The foam in here also acts as a vibration damper, or a tuned mass damper. You guys seen any of my vlogs in Taipei, and I go up to the top of Taipei 101, they have a massive damper ball up there. Here's the principle of how it works, a vibrating structure with mass on top and springs in between to absorb and eliminate any vibration that occurs. When this was explained to me, I was like, you already put foam in here. It's bonkers that they actually engineered it that way as well. So I'm very curious to see maybe some independent reviews on this model when it actually comes out. But again, we're looking at Q1 2026 for that to launch. And oh yes, it will include the new Gen 2 fans. All right, lastly, or second to lastly, we have a thermosiphon, actually a two-phase thermosiphon. You guys, here's the prototype unit that they have on display right here. And if you guys aren't familiar with how a thermosiphon works, it works with phase change. Cold liquid comes in this side, vaporizes here, and it gets pushed up through the radiator where it cools by the fans and then changes phase back to liquid, and then the cycle continues. This means that the pressure for this loop is being created by that phase change, which means you don't need a pump. You can see the vaporization happening right in there, which is pretty cool. Oh, also my reflection. Hi. So the main advantage here is that you don't have a pump, which means pump failure is not going to be an issue, as it can be with certain AIOs. And then beyond that, Noctua said the main issue to deal with is permeation over time through the tubes. But they said as they develop this, they're fairly confident that they're going to be able to get about a 10-year lifespan out of their thermosiphon units. There is no ETA on this quite yet because, as I mentioned, Noctua has been quite honest about some of the challenges with developing this product. Look, that's what it says, the hotspot challenge. So I'm not going to get too much into the physics of this because honestly, it's a little bit beyond me. But as liquid boils, it doesn't just boil and then stop boiling. There's some phases, and as it starts to boil and heat gets input, you can have vapor pockets that form at the bottom of that chamber. In a worst case scenario, you can have an entire film of vapor that pushes there, and that's actually going to prevent the thermosiphon from cooling properly. We've gone through several phases of cold plate development for this. I think it's pretty fascinating because these cold plates look way different than the cold plates you would have on a typical AIO, where you have micro fins and a pump that's pushing the liquid through. Long story short though, they are still working on that hotspot challenge effect in order to get the performance of the thermosiphon up on par with all-in-one liquid coolers. Right now it is functional. They have a demo running right over here, and it is cooling a 9800X3D on an X670E Hero motherboard with that game running on loop, but they said in terms of the actual cooling performance is still not quite where it should be, and that's because of the metal bubbles, those little vapor pockets. We started with the fan, let's finish with fans too. The Noctua NF814X25 was a very popular fan that came out last year, very much best in class in terms of 14mm fans, and now Noctua has made them in black, as they often do. They come out with their Noctua colors first. Changing the color of the LCP is not quite as simple as just adding a few drops of food coloring or anything like that, but Noctua has managed to do it, and expect these to come out in September of this year. Well, hey, that was fun. Noctua has a lot of stuff to show off, so I'm glad to stop by. I want to say a big thank you to my sponsors for Computex 2025, G-Skill, Thermaltake, Trikes, Cooler Master, and Gigabytes. I have made a lot of videos, but I still have more coming, so check the playlist down below. Hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed this one. Big thank you to Noctua for having me over. We'll see you guys in the next video. Hey.